coming up from the Mile High City. The Broncos play host to the Jets. Denver's looking for win number 7 in their last 9 games against New York. It's week 3 in the NFL, next on EA Sports.
We find ourselves at the foot of the Rockies, Denver, Colorado, for this edition of the NFL on EA Sports. Just a short time ago, sounds loud enough to reverberate across the Rockies. They're ready for football in Denver as the Broncos get set to do battle with the New York Jets. Charles Davis. And Charles, we look at this Bronco team. It's an early test here after 2 losses to start the season and a game they probably really need.
Obviously, no way do they want to get to 0-3. Right. Not many teams make the playoffs with that kind of a start.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Jets, they too were losers last week, so they're also hoping to get back in the win column.
Something's got to give in this one, right? Both teams want to start a new streak, and they both want it to be a victory. This should be a fun one.
After a good punt, this offense will start with tough field position inside the 10. Looks like he's going to get a couple here on this first down carry, and that'll make it 2nd and 8. Charles, we'll take a look there at the draft class for the New York Jets. Robert Saleh, the new head coach, he's got his quarterback as they took Zach Wilson, number 2, and moved Sam Darnold down to Carolina.
And we might end up saying that Elijah Moore out of Ole Miss, taken at number 34, could go down as one of the steals in the draft. The wide receiver is drawing rave reviews as far back as the OTAs. And one other one that we should note, how about how they manipulated the draft, traded at number 14 to take the guard Elijah Vera Tucker out of USC to protect Zach Wilson.
To throw on 3rd down, Fountain. They'll set up the screen to Carter. And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line. So Charles, first drive here, a little safe completion underneath, maybe get some rhythm, get your feet wet, so to speak.
I agree, and I like it because it's a lot like a basketball game when you're getting started and you pass the ball around so everyone touches it early and gets involved in the game. In this case, it's not just dumping it to a back and he's able to run with the ball, but you get your offensive linemen involved because they get to get out and run and hit people in the open field. Everyone getting their feet wet early.
Hey, double Von Miller, man. I'm trying to get my head blown off.
To throw on 2nd down, Fountain. That's to the veteran tight end, Carter Landry. The reception good for 7. It's 3rd down. Back to throw, Fountain. He'll be brought down by the Broncos. It's a sack. The man wreaking havoc there, Gerald McCoy, the knee tackle. Now the Jets send on Braden Mann to punt. K.J. Hamler deep for the Broncos. He'll send this one into the mile high air, and it's a good one. It's taken to the 26. Now a hit and a loose football, and the Jets have recovered. Was hoping to make a play there on the return with... And now before the ball changes hands, I'm going to take a look at this just to make sure... So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble. Shifts past him at the 40. Breaks the tackle. He's got room to run. And all the way down to the 22-yard line. 42 yards rushing for him now, and just his first 3 carries.
Why am I
now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here.
Yeah, why am I playing defense?
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. A gain of 8 there on the play, and it's a second down. And he'll get this only up to about the 35. A nice play design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but bottom line, the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked on it all week in practice. They drilled on the play, then they drilled him.
Man open is Keelan Cole, complete. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. It's a big play that time by the Jets.
One of the things that led this organization to commit to him as a starting quarterback as a rookie, his ability to keep his eyes downfield and make plays out of the pocket, able to see the receiver while on the move and complete a really accurate throw.
On first and 10, it's Carter. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, second down. The Jets with the football here to start the second quarter. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Had his hands on it, but dropped it. The rookie making a little bit of a rookie mistake. Third down. The Jets on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. Flushed out right. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down.
A very important third down conversion right there, because when you're trailing and find yourself this deep in enemy territory, the kicker's not even part of your thought process. You got to make it pay off with 6. Nice connection right there to set up first and goal.
And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up 2nd down.
That's a really alert defense there, because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the 5 down to the 3. They'll look to throw on 3rd and goal. And that is pulled in by Herndon for a Jets touchdown. Chris Herndon, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Jets are an extra point away from tying this thing up. There was a lot of zip on that pass, and baseball might have called that a frozen rope.
I like it when you bring the diamond into the game. I'm going back to the gridiron. Had some heat on that bad boy. Sometimes you throw a touchdown pass, and sometimes...
you throw, what, a touchdown strike?
There you go. That's my...
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. The last possession, these guys were able to tie the game with a touchdown, and now they'll have a chance to move out in front.
Yeah, let's give a big assist to the defense who got the ball back. The special teams went out there, handled things. They've got it. They've got momentum. I know they're eager to get out there and put it on.
First down, Fountain. Man open here is Crowder. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. So a 1st and 10 now in Denver territory at the 39-yard line. Looking to throw. Fountain flush to his right. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be 2nd down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
A quick throw out wide, caught by Crowder. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets it down to the 30 there. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there, swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
The Jets on third down. They've been near perfect. 4 for 5 to this point. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. He's not going to get there. That won't even be close. It was blown up in the backfield. So they'll pass on what would have been a 49-yard field goal attempt, and they're going for it on fourth down. Off play action. Fountain escaping the pressure right. He's going to have his running back. It's complete. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10.
And that's a big pickup of a first down. And you know that all week, both sides of the ball, offense and defense, are going through every situation. And in this case, the offensive guys had the right play dialed up because defensively, you work on fourth down situations as well.
Yeah, deflating for the defense. They can't get the stop here. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9. We've hit the 2 minute mark of the first half, all knotted up at 7. Looking to throw on 2nd down. Fountain. And he's got it. Touchdown, Jets. Keelan Cole. His 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Jets are
good read. Good read. Good job, defense.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive.
Yeah.
It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity.
What you got for me, Crowder?
Fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by Justin Simmons. Again, the juke. And a return across midfield and to the 46-yard line.
Yeah, I know. Damn.
So the offense set to take the field here. They will have the football with less than a minute to go in the first half. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Now he'll let it go deep right side. And that's caught inside the 35.
Get out of bounds.
And all the way inside the 35 before he goes out of bounds. A big play there just before halftime.
There's the arm strength that we saw in college and during the scouting process. And really, it's not just the arm strength there, but the placement as well. To me, that was an excellent combination of arm talent and
single
accuracy.
Cover. What we got? Cover 2? See the man that's cover 2.
Throwing on first down.
Shit.
And the pressure will get to him. He goes down. Now there is a flag on the play, but this looks like holding on the offense. So they will take the sack instead of the penalty.
And it takes another down off the series. But the biggest one of all, do you want to tell the guy who just got the sack that it no longer counts?
No.
No, not at all.
So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. So this will be spotted on the midfield logo. It's a 58-yard attempt. And I tell you what, he got it from 58. That has it.
All right. All right, back on offense.
So they surrendered 3 points, so now after the kickoff, this offense gets ready to take over the football. It's P. Ryan to begin the drive. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39.
Mike Williamson,
good
run. A big
hole there. How about him handling the point of attack? Just positioning himself so that
everyone
can go right off of his backside and deep into the secondary.
Good job, Crowder.
Right side and complete. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35.
And Crowder's now in his third year with the Jets after four in Washington. A dependable route runner, he makes a nice catch there.
They'll run on first down.
Good juke.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
A good strong run there by Michael Carter, reminiscent of his days at North Carolina. A 1,000-yard rusher each of his last 2 years in Chapel Hill, despite being at a timeshare with Javonte Williams, who was a second-round pick of the Denver Broncos. Carter, the second pick of the fourth round, out of UNC. He could be the Jets' leading rusher moving forward.
The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard. Operating from the gun. Fountain. Throw complete to Herndon.
That was a route run not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to 1.
And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. Carter once more.
Ah.
And there is nowhere for him to cut back as he's taken down.
Ring Randy right at bottom of the line. Didn't even think about it.
Third down and 9.
Come on, Moore. Moore, you gotta give me something, dog.
Back to throw. Fountain.
Oh, Cole, good save.
He hits him in stride. Touchdown.
Good save, Cole.
With his second TD of the game, his 6th on the year.
Good save, Cole. Because I got hit.
Remember, partner, that's
oh, my God. All right, up 3
Jets
in the 4th.
Coming up now to start their next drive. Their lead back down to 1 score after the touchdown a moment ago. First down's a must on this drive as they start out here 1st and 10.
All right. Get up the field.
And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. 2nd down. I'm sure that that's going to be the formula. Just keep the ball on the ground. Keep that clock moving.
And when you have the lead this late in the game, above all, stay in bounds. Yes, take care of the football. Yes, gain yardage, but stay in bounds.
Good stuff. Let's get the first.
Down,
good first.
Slip across the 35.
Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air.
Go.
Even on 1st and 2nd down.
You got to block them.
Obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
Just a yard on the 1st down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
Still 9 remaining on 2nd down. On the catch, it's Crowder.
Let's go, Crowder. Good play.
Got staying in bounds, though. Before he takes it inside the 40.
Yeah, staying in bounds,
though. Offense like you drive. The pedal is down. Stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. On the Jets sweep, here comes
Let's go. Good job, Moore.
And they're able to get
good
this
play.
One past
good
the 30
play.
Down to the 25.
Good play. Let's go. Keep it up.
I think the reason this play is so successful is not just the blocking at the point of attack, but how about the speed at which he takes the handoff? He's in motion already, so he's not coming from a flat start like a running back often is. He's at a full run by the time he gets the football.
And on the stop there, Alexander Johnson, the Broncos' leading tackle last year. If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up 2nd down. Another tote for Carter. Give him 3 yards, and now they're left needing a conversion here on 3rd and 6. Now the objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but work some clock.
Yeah, you're exactly right, but the problem for them is still within a possession, so they can't just
All right,
sit
Von Miller's right there.
Tough to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
Okay.
3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the 4th. So it's Jets football as we get your reset here. They've got a 3rd down, but they are in field goal range. Already.
Oh, my God.
Oh, no, he lost the football.
Jesus.
The Broncos say they have it. They do.
Jesus, he threw that man to the ground. I wasn't ready. Why he throw that guy to the ground like that? Yo, no, no, no. No. Heck no. No, we gotta talk about that. That was wild.
Back to throw.
That was insane. Everyone's doubled.
And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down. So following the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 25.
You got it. I got it. You got to double that. I don't think he's blocking now.
He'll look to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield.
Boom!
This is dropped. Oh, it's incomplete. He had a big gainer in his sights, but he could not reel it in. An important play right here, third and 10.
I needed, we needed here. That. We needed that. I can't tell if this is man coverage or what it is.
They'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. And that's caught inside
Let's go.
The 35.
Good freaking catch.
Inside the 35 before he goes out of bounds.
Good catch. Needed that.
The
big catch.
And I believe the referee is going to take another look at the...
Woo! Good stuff. We needed that. Hey, hey.
So the folks in New York just going to wind up confirming
that
the official
saw double this
play will stand as is.
There he is.
That's complete as he goes right back to Crowder. And he's down inside.
Let's go.
At the four before he's out of bounds. Working the sideline there. Good route, good catch. First down, and he gets out of bounds.
Yeah, I have to like the play calling because you have to run some guys down the middle of the field to draw some of the defenders away. They can't just let them guard the sideline exclusively. Mm-hmm. That's how it's going to work. Sidelines and incompletions to use the clock.
Come on.
Only
come
way
on.
To get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal.
Different yards.
Carter, and he will push his way forward down about the 3-yard line. Only a yard that time. Second and goal. Good first step there defensively, but they're still knocking on the doorstep. So maybe another run here?
I think so. One of my favorite coaches, you say, son, if you could darn near lay down near the end zone and get in, give me my best power running play with my best back right now.
It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a third and goal. For the lead, here's third and goal. It's a quarterback sneak, and this is going to depend on the spot, but I believe he might be a few inches short. Likely the play of the game here, trailing in the final quarter, and he's
Let's
across
go.
From a touchdown.
We're in there.
It's likely the game winner here in the closing stages.
For the win, fellas. For
what?
The
it
win.
Got done. They now have the lead with that touchdown. This
That's all we needed.
Contest. I wonder if that was
That's
a play
all we needed right there.
Or a play that they just knew would work from past experience.
Well, I just saw it in their eyes on the sideline before
That's
starting
all we
that
needed.
Last
it was just
drive.
A little bit,
and
man.
They did. You're right. Well, partner, still a head scratcher to me how this one ended. Down three. I just thought, you know, no matter the situation,
got the dub.
A spot where you can kick that field goal, go to overtime,
hey,
why not do it?
Hey,
and this is where I think the analytics guys are going to continue to get more and more traction in the league. You know, we've talked about different people now saying, I need a game management coach, someone in the booth to take the emotion out of it. Did they lose track of where they were on the clock, right? Did they lose track of where they were on the field? Was it makeable for their kicker? All those things come into play here. And it turns out they don't get it done.
So for the Jets, they get back in the win column as they move to 2-1 now on the year. And they will head home next week to take on the Tennessee Titans.
Got
Meanwhile, for the Broncos, the early struggles continue as they'll sink to 0-3. And they'll
Let's
be at home
go.
For one next week as the Baltimore Ravens come to town.
My boy with the cleanest touchdown pass right there. Clean. Cole had two of them things. Von Miller ran over my tackle. Jesus, man came off the edge. He's supposed to be double teaming this dude. Instead, you watch him get bodied. I probably had that late and I didn't see it. That was late. I didn't see it late. On the sideline, though. Good dive in there. Good dive in there for the touchdown. That's what we need, that. That's a clutch. Clutch for the win. For the win, needed. We needed that one.
I was talking with my crew before the show. By the way, best production team in the biz, or at least that's what they tell me to say. Anyway, I think it's worth discussing on air for this podcast the new Nike commercial they debuted last night. It was not good. It was amazing. You get all these dramatic shots with NFL stars like Lamar Jackson and Russell Wilson. But get this, the final shot, they reserve it for the rookie QB from New York as he puts on his Jets helmet and just stares a hole through the camera. I'm talking a serious mean mug. I mean, look at this. I'm getting goosebumps just thinking about it. Of course, some people just can't enjoy a good thing. They're saying it's too much, too soon, blah, blah, blah. But look, that's the get off my lawn crowd anyway. It's not like the kid directed the commercial. He just appears in it. I mean, you tell me. I mean, how many people out there would say no to being in a Nike commercial that gets splashed across primetime TV? Anyone? Anyone? Bueller? I mean, we're talking about Nike here. Look, anyway, enough about all that. Why don't we get to the segment we actually had planned before I went off on that diatribe? And you know what? It's a good one for a lot of reasons. So,
all right, my guys. Okay. Casey is up there.
Thank you.